tech news right here.
Wait, what'd you just say?
You heard me.
We're doing tech news today?
That's right, doggy.
Yes! Yes! Ah! I love it! Valve has fully taken the wraps off its fancy VR headset, the Index. While the HTC Vive was a joint project developed by both Valve and HTC, the Index is a fully Valve-only creation. It has the same dual 1440 by 1600 LCD panels as the Vive Pro, but each pixel has 3 subpixels instead of 2, which reportedly helps to greatly reduce the screen door effect. Other features include a 120Hz screen with an experimental 144Hz mode, whew, an FOV higher than the HTC Vive by about 20 degrees, and dual exterior cameras with pass-through. An entire VR package with 2 base stations, 2 controllers, and the headset costs $999 US. But the Index is compatible with existing Lighthouse base stations, so if you already have a Vive, you can just get the headset for $499 or the controllers for $279. Although it seems like a small price to pay to experience Valve's flagship VR game that is almost certainly a Half-Life or Portal VR game that's coming later this year. Is it though? Because I thought that ship had kind of sailed. Remember Steam Machines?
How could I forget?
I can't trust Valve. Speaking of companies that started out cool and then became soulless corporations, Facebook hosted their F8 developer conference yesterday and announced some big changes coming to the social network. A fairly drastic redesign will highlight Facebook groups and events rather than the traditional newsfeed. Messenger will focus more on close friends and get a desktop app, and Instagram will get more camera features and the option to hide like counts. How am I supposed to know how many people liked my photos?
What will I live for?
Yeah, what's the point? But Facebook also had some VR news, opening up pre-orders for the Oculus Quest and Rift S, which will both cost $399 US. The Quest is a standalone headset powered by a Snapdragon 835, which is actually pretty awesome, according to Ars Technica, while the Rift S is meant to be connected to a PC as a slight upgrade over the original Rift.
Are you sure it's not just pronounced Rifts?
Rifts? Get your Rifts. Get your Rifts, boys. These events are always slightly depressing because they remind us how many things Facebook owns. Oh, right, yeah, they own everything. Do they own Google yet?
They own your data.
Not if Google has anything to say about it, but that's for later.
Oh.
Speaking of depressing, because I said depressing at some point, I guess, Huawei! The company faced fresh accusations of spying this week, courtesy of Bloomberg. The news outlet reported that European mobile network operator Vodafone found back doors in Huawei equipment back in 2009 and 2011. But Vodafone themselves defended Huawei against the claims, saying they notified Huawei of security vulnerabilities in their equipment and Huawei fixed them. But the Bloomberg reports claim that despite Huawei's fixes, the vulnerabilities were still there in 2012. Now, some experts are pushing back, saying that the back door that they found is simply the Telnet access feature, which is extremely common on home routers. Now, that doesn't mean that there weren't backdoors or that Huawei wasn't abusing its equipment's Telnet access feature, but it's not really a smoking gun either. So we'll just have to chalk this up as another entry in the
no collusion.
Yeah, not really conclusive evidence, but it still makes Huawei look kind of bad category. One of those.
Exonerated!
Now it's time for Quick Bits, brought to you by Brilliant. Every day, Brilliant publishes several daily challenges that provide a quick and fascinating view into math, logic, engineering, science, or computer science, or other sciences too. Whether you're stuck in a commute or just want to learn something new every day, Brilliant's daily challenges are a fun, bite-sized way to master concepts by applying them. Each challenge comes with illustrations, animations, or interactive visualizations, that sounds like a rap, and all the context you need to solve it yourself. So head over to brilliant.org/techlinked and finish your day a little bit smarter. Maybe you'll have glasses like me by the end. The first 200 of you to do so will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. I want you to join the Quick Bits. Just in time to troll Facebook's new attempts at protecting their users' privacy, Google is rolling out an option to automatically delete your activity data after either 3 months or 18 months. That doesn't sound very finely tuned, but it's apparently only the first of many privacy-oriented features to come. But they're not quite as good as Apple, because what happens on an iPhone stays on an iPhone, and we all know that.
It's just as true in Vegas.
What happens on a Pixel also stays on a Pixel for 3 months. In other Google news, today the tech giant revealed Calljoy, an AI-powered call answering service for businesses, which can take notes for business owners to review later and can even take food orders if you're a restaurant. So if you make a reservation with Duplex, it might end up talking to CallJoy and then...
DoJoy.
For just... CallPlex. It'll all just be AIs talking to each other in the end, and we'll just be chilling.
That's all we're doing. That's what we are.
That's what I want.
I'm a biological machine.
Fair enough. Microsoft is bumping up the minimum storage requirements for Windows 10 in the upcoming May update. Both 32-bit and 64-bit systems will now need a minimum of 32 gigabytes of storage space for the Windows installation. So you might want to clear out a bit of space before you update.
I can't delete my songs!
Well... The change is partially to have backup so we don't get a repeat of the horrendous file-deleting catastrophe that was the October update, and partially because it's far past time you cleaned out your downloads folder. It's disgusting in there. Intel's upcoming Z GPUs will support hardware acceleration for ray tracing, or at least the data center versions will. We don't have any more information regarding Intel's consumer graphics cards, but if the PlayStation 5 is gonna have it, I mean, wait, consoles with glorious ray tracing versus PC peasants?
Console master race.
That doesn't sound right. No. And robotics company Anki has announced they are shutting down. The company made the Cosmo and the Vector, little Pixar looking bots that were not super useful, but were adorable as all heck. And I'm sad to see them go. And it's time to put down this episode. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe if you love tech news. Like the video if you just like tech news. And if you're not sure how you feel, leave a comment telling us all about your confusion. We'll work through it together.
Or else I'll put you down out back.